release me, right? You pay money, and maybe I get found. Once you're found, it's not just you getting the lead, right? You actually have to compete for that. Mm-hmm. It's usually one out of four, one out of five agents that's getting that lead, right? And they have to go after that and pursue. And at the end of that, you still don't own the customer, because they go right back into the pool. Because Google, if this is the Google funnel, right? People are coming here to find who? Riffin. To find Trulia. Why Riffin is working? Riffin stole this model, right? And said, we want to be found. You can find properties on our site anywhere, all the time. I'm going to be right. On top of that, I'm going to be able to close you if I'm a woman. They figured that out. That's why this thing's popping. Now, they changed the model from a traditional commission base, right? To a whole new thing, because they have the base. You make a base, and then all these perks, fits, right? However, they want to gamify that in order for their agents to make. So it's like, they may be less, make less money, but I think Redfin agents typically have more stable stability on income. So they have a license, they can do that. So it's kind of got on my head, like, why wouldn't you be owning? It's one thing we talk about in marketing, and the whole reason focus on tools like CRM is for ownership. I want to know who they are, when they are, right? How did they get to me? Where they've been? It's like super stalking of your customers. That's what technology is available to do today. Yeah, most realtors I see is go to my website. There's another thing in there called search, right? You can find properties and whatnot. But as a realtor, how much of data, of that data, are you getting exposed and have access to? Do you have any idea when people go to your website, superwholesalerealtor.com, and start searching for homes in Minneapolis, right? Do not which homes they looked at. You have no idea. Because guess what? You're simply renting that tool, that technology, right? That customer of someone else. See, some people talk about marketing, they say content is king. Content is not king. Data is king. There's a huge difference. So that's why when I get passionate about this, is because from my background, what I've done, data drives everything. We make billions of dollars of data. And I talk about that all day long. Today, right, I was on a better loan officer project. Let's come back to data. They didn't lock down data, therefore they can't monetize well. Real estate is doing the same thing. So if you send your customers and maybe go there, or go over there, find an MLS number or something, right? And then come back to me and I will help you with that next leg. Well, you don't know what's going on at all. So to what Ron was saying earlier, when I look at social media, I think we feel the same way. Social media is huge, and it's going to continue to grow. Platforms going to change, new technologies is going to be coming out, right? I need to be an efficient agent. That means I need to dominate my customers slash prospects that I have not met yet. In order to do that, I have to dominate the tools. Because if I don't have control over the tools, right, I can be very efficient in communicating with them. I can't reach this. So you don't need to own a Trulia, but you need to own the concept. So who are you? How can customer communicate with you most effectively? Right? That set of communication style that you have suits what kind of prospect. Right? Some prospect will never want email. Some prospect never want a Facebook email or text. But if they knew since the 2000s, they want to meet you. They want to sit down, have pie, have coffee, get to know you a little bit, right? That is one kind of customer, but is that your kind of customer? So you have to put a value on that cost. Is when you're having that cup of coffee, you spend that 1 hour meeting someone,
from my side, when I put money hat on, I look at opportunity cost, right? How much time do you need to invest in that kind of customer in order to win one business deal? Versus if you have more efficient, tactical approach with the best suited customer, right, that can use technology that you use. What if the ratio becomes 2-to-1, maybe 5-to-1? That's a tremendous bottom line difference, right? So we look at stuff completely, when we look at social media, I look at, oh my gosh, this is a little thing, right? How do I manage all of that? You need a whole team to do that, right? I personally am going through the process of becoming email free by the end of this year. I would never send another email by the end of 2015. So that's pretty crazy.
Yeah, I've been close to little to nothing this year.
Yeah, I don't even respond to people's emails, really, unless they're sending me money.
It's too slow. It's too slow of a process.
I tell people, call me or text me. Otherwise, you Facebook me, because I can respond to you right away, because I'm Facebook Messenger. Don't tweet me, because too much stuff going on, right? And that the responsiveness doesn't happen. That's why Twitter finally changed from 140 character limitation to unlimited, basically, into direct messaging, because it became useless.
Yep.
So that was not a tool of choice for me, right? So I need to find the best way to be the best kind of people, the person to serve the right kind of customer. And I think it's when they're talking about the right dollar. A lot of people in sales and so forth, they think every dollar is my dollar. But to me, that's a very immature thing. Someone who has not grinded in the system long enough to realize there's a right dollar. So the other day I was on the system chatting with a bunch of people, I tell them, you need to go after the right dollar. What does that mean? You can imagine a dollar with either you know, your awesome face on it, or as a picture, right? And trust service, so you get that. It's totally out. Here you go, little window, chimney. The right kind of homes that you are master of. The right kind of service you provide. Because that is always talking about this. So to visualizing that, if I visualize you, I look at you, I right away make a biased judgment. We all do that. So by having a lot of practice, I right away start processing, right? Are you the right kind of person to engage with me and vice versa in what way? If there's no fit on the business end, I'm already making that decision in my mind. How I'm going to engage with you, how much time I'm going to spend with you. So knowing this becomes very important in order to do